Welcome to the second episode of Covering Guts in Blackpowder Lore. Today, we'll be covering the map that's most voted for in every single server, San Sebastian. Before we begin, I want to say thanks for all the support on my channel recently. The subs, the likes, the views, I really appreciate it. Alright, let's begin. We're starting off with some historical context. The Siege of San Sebastian was a historical battle that started on July 7th of the year 1813. It was a part of the Spanish uprising against Napoleon. For those of you who don't know, Napoleon conquered Spain and its population started a revolt, resulting in guerrilla warfare that you can consider Napoleon's Vietnam. The Battle of San Sebastian had the town defended by the French while the British and Portuguese tried to take the city. When the British and Portuguese eventually took the city, they burned and murdered everything in their path, including civilians. This might be a reason for the insane amount of zombies this map throws at you. The map takes place in mid to late 1813, after Vardo's fortress, since Vardo's takes place in late 1812, early 1813. The British and the Portuguese, who have already taken the city of San Sebastian, only have to capture the French fortification up the hill in order to achieve victory. However, strange things seem to happen as the soldiers try to reorganize their forces. We know this because of some sneaky Easter eggs spread around the map. We now shortly follow the story of Jonathan Baker, a soldier in the British Army. His corpse can be found in one of the buildings near the port in San Sebastian. He had shot himself with a pistol during the initial outbreak of the infection in order to prevent further infection. He left a few notes. His first note can be found at this location, in a broken bottle. A bottle that was most likely intended to be thrown in sea. The letter reads as follows. A few rankers passed off of consumption this morning. Perhaps they were slumbering, but they awoke with a bloodlust. A poor chap got a better look at the two, and they lunged at him, ripped his throat out. I couldn't tell you what happened afterwards, but more and more men became afflicted with this bloodlust. The streets were teeming with this man-eating cannibals. Our officer held us up in a house. To the naval frigates outside of San Sebastian, please organize an extraction effort. We've taken devastating losses, and we're in no condition to confront the French, let alone are the French in any condition to contest the cannibals roaming the streets. However, I fear the best course of action is to bombard these savages until they can do no harm. To any civilians who discovered this letter, deliver these to any of His Majesty's soldiers. Jonathan Baker. His second letter, lying next to his corpse, goes as followed. Don't bother sending anyone. I got it all figured out. As soon as the infection spread around the city, the French in their fortification free their British and Portuguese prisoners of war. Together, they decide to set aside their conflict and unite in order to fight the hordes of the undead and make it down to the fort. To the city wall, in order to be safe by, you guessed it, the HMS Undaunted. The survivors blow up a shack to get planks to aid their escape. After fighting a giant horde of runners, you can see the HMS Undaunted slowly appear near the coast. The survivors encounter more hordes of the undead and use a winch to get supplies to make it to the fort facing the city walls. They fight their way through the city. Their sabers clash with the shamblers, men dying left and right. It's a bloodbath. Finally, when the survivors reach the city wall, they meet the man, the myth, the legend. You know him, you love him, Barry. Barry offers to bring up and lower a platform to help the remaining survivors get down to the shore. However, the undead approach, and they are many. Sadly, Barry falls victim to the undead. A runner with only red eyes because the devs were too lazy tackles him, and soon a bomber follows, killing him instantly. One survivor has to sacrifice his life to save the others. As the platform is lowered, the remaining survivors have their last stand. One last fight, one last push. A sailor in a rowboat reaches the shore, and surviving players are rewarded with the Forlorn Hope badge. a reference to a painting about the siege of San Sebastian. Even though these survivors have done the impossible, the story of San Sebastian does not end on a happy note. Following the lore, one of the survivors is indeed infected and kills the captain of the HMS Undaunted. This might be how the infection spread around the European mainland further. At this point in the timeline, the brutal Napoleonic Wars are still raging on, however soon that will change. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope to see you in the next episode.